So you guys seem to like my building muscle with push-up tip video, so here's some more tips for you. This video is more about getting out of the rut of pattern where people were doing push-ups with the arms way on out, splayed out to the side, and how to move more into this sort of deal, because this is the gateway towards more advanced push-up techniques that are gonna help you keep moving and building more muscle, because you can't expect to continue to get much bigger and stronger while doing push-ups the same way. With calisthenics, you progress through adjusting your technique. So if you're not adjusting your technique to a higher level, it's kind of like always lifting the same weight and wondering why you're never getting bigger and stronger. So bringing yourself out of this sort of mentality, out of this sort of technique, is one of the gateways that I find a lot of people struggle with. Part of it's this notion that using the chest is optimal when the elbows are way out to the side, because of course your chest muscle is responsible for adduction of the humerus. However, there's another way that you can use the chest, which is through keeping your arms tight into your chest, and rather than moving your arms inwards through adduction, you use your chest to maintain adduction as you move your hands forward and up. This takes a little bit of neural circuitry rewiring in order to do. A good way to start practicing this is to use some rings or suspension straps with what they call RTO push-ups. I used to call these Maltese or underhanded push-ups, because it allows you to get the feeling for what it's like to press while trying to adduct your arms inwards through the range of motion. And you'll understand very quickly how your chest is responsible for this, and it is very effective for keeping your chest on. You don't need to just necessarily always move your arms in and back. Once you kind of get that notion, that exercise down, start working on just being able to proactively engage your chest with your arms down by your sides when you're standing. This is a very important step to be able to engage your chest so that when you get into a push-up position, your chest fires on. Because after all, how do you expect to build and strengthen a muscle that you have trouble engaging in the first place? So just practicing, you can squeeze your arms when you're in their pockets down by your side on a regular basis, keep your back tight as well, and just kind of squeezing everything inwards throughout the day. And that will build up that neural mind muscle connection so you can tense and engage your chest and your back at will much more easily. Then over time, you don't need to go right from wide to narrow immediately. It can be a little rough on the wrist, a little rough on the shoulders. So start walking in gradually with each workout, coming in a little bit closer with your hands, a little bit more narrow with the arms. Also pay attention to where your forearms are and your hands are in relation to your chest. If you are doing push-ups and your shoulders are hunched up, when you come down, you're gonna have this splaying, spreading apart kind of motion here. This is hard on the shoulder joint, hard on the wrist, as you can see, and there's a gap between my arm and my body. I'm exaggerating here. What you wanna do is get your chest and back involved to bring your arms in tight and have your hands slightly more forward. This way you're pushing more along here and creating more of this rotation, this supination, while you're doing your pushing motion rather than pronation where everything comes on up. That's gonna get a little bit more of that tension as well. So getting to be masterful at pushing like this will open up the potential for more advanced exercises, because then you start walking one arm out and it's gonna be a lot harder for that one arm to be working for you. The other bonus is you don't have to start going after these one-arm push-ups where your arm is way out to the side, your legs are sprayed, and you're torquing and twisting the hell out of your spine, which can be rough on some of those muscles in your back. Check out my push-up videos here. Check out more comments down below. Be fit, live free.